This is Christina Harris with WPBeginner.com. Today I'll show you how to save images that are optimized for the web to speed up your site. So here's a scenario. You go on vacation, you take lots of beautiful photos, and you want to share them on your site. So you upload them all directly from your camera, and all of a sudden your site seems to be running a little slower. Well, it's likely because you uploaded several photos that were very large, and it's slowing everything down. The larger the resolution is great for printing photos on photo paper, but the web is a little bit different, and in order to save your images, you need to consider two things. One, the image file format, and two, the compression. Getting these two right can reduce the file size by as much as 5 times. So the two file formats that we're going to talk about are JPEG and PNG. You want to use JPEG format for images or photos that have a lot of color. And you want to use the PNG format with simpler images or if you need to keep a transparent background. So what's the difference between the two? PNGs are not compressed, and that makes it great for a higher quality. But the bad thing is that they also typically have a higher file size. And conversely, you'll have a JPEG image, which is compressed, so you lose a little bit of quality, but has a much smaller footprint or a much smaller file size. And now you want to think about compression. And all that means is it can reduce the overall file size of your image, but you need a tool to do this. So what can you use to optimize your images for the web? Well, the first one we'll cover is Photoshop. And here I have it, and I have a rather large photo. And you can see the file size here, and that's pretty large for websites. Go to the File, and choose Save for Web. Once that comes up, you'll see the image size here, and you have different formats over here. You want to play with these settings, and when you click on the drop-down for JPEG or PNG, you see the difference in file size and image quality. Choose the one that is best for you to use. Play with these settings to see the difference in file size and image quality, and pick the best one to use. For instance, I'll pick the JPEG High. You see how much the file size drops? Once I'm happy with the file size and quality, I can just click Save, give it a name, and my photo is ready to upload to my website. Now we know that Photoshop is a large investment, and it might not be the right choice for some, but you also have free alternatives such as GIMP that you can work with. The next tool is TinyPNG, which is a free web app, and it compresses PNG files. They've also made compressing images a little bit fun, and I'll show you how. I'll just upload a PNG file and watch while TinyPNG compresses it and shows me the before and after and how much smaller it made the image. And from here, I can download the file to my computer, and now it's ready for my website. The last tool I want to cover is for the JPEG file type, and it's called JPEG Mini. On their homepage, they'll show you a great example of how much their tool can reduce the image size without reducing the perceived quality. So I'm going to click on the Try Now button, upload one of my photos that needs reducing. I'll drag it over here, and you see it's uploading. Once the upload's complete, JPEG Mini shows me the original size and the amount reduced. And again, now my photo is ready to upload. So use these techniques on all your photos to speed up your site.
I hope you liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, click on the like button below and leave us a comment. And if you want to receive more helpful videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and check out WP Beginner for more useful information on WordPress.